2013 is coming to an end, and boy, what an year it has been for smartphones. We are starting to fit 5 to 6 inch devices with full HD resolutions in our pockets, which can also run some super powerful apps thanks to the new processors that clock 2 GHz and above. More megapixels, longer battery life, and a refreshing cycle of software updates had dawned upon us this year through some of the best smartphones in the market. So which ones are the best smartphones of 2013? We picked our top 10, so let's find out what they are. Let's start with the most obvious, the Apple iPhone 5S. Seen as an evolutionary upgrade, it packs the super fast but also the first 64-bit processor, has a golden color variant and Touch ID, a biometric fingerprint sensor to read your prints. As always, it's the best iPhone yet with the latest iOS 7 update. Next up, it's arch rival, the Samsung Galaxy S4. It got a bigger Full HD screen, a faster octa-core processor or a Snapdragon 600 processor, a better camera and even several new sensors for pressure, temperature and so on. It too has a gold edition now, by the way. But then, as we have repeatedly mentioned, Samsung doesn't have one but two flagships. The Samsung Galaxy Note 3 massively improves upon its predecessor. We have a bigger Full HD screen, a newer stylus, a faster octa-core or Snapdragon 800 processor, and best of all, a new leather-like back and super thin and light design. Possibly one of the costliest phones in the market that might be well worth its money right now. Time for some Korean rivalry. So next on the list we have the LG G2. Sporting all the top-end specifications you would expect, like an edge-to-edge Full HD screen, Snapdragon 800 and a 13-megapixel camera, the G2 is also the first phone to have controls on its back, a solid first in the industry, but it is also a great phone with amazing battery life. Moving on, we have the HTC One that launched earlier in the year with a great Full HD screen and a camera that bucks the megapixel trend with bigger pixel sizes. This has been HTC's flagship till now and is still one of the best looking Android phones ever with a beautiful aluminium unibody. Talking of unibody, if there is another company that religiously follows this design, that would be Nokia. Months before it got acquired by Microsoft, it released the Lumia 1020, the successor to the 808 PureView, with a 41 megapixel camera with optical image stabilization and oversampling. Best camera phone, period. Next up, we have the Google Nexus 5, made by LG. Building upon the success of the Nexus 4, it catches up with the rest of the industry trends like a Full HD display, a faster processor, and a better camera with optical image stabilization. But of course, the promise of instant updates stayed true for this Nexus 2, which runs Android 4.4 KitKat out of the box. Next up, we have the Sony Xperia Z1, also known as a better Z. Possibly the best Android camera phone on the market, the Z1 continues the waterproof trend and catches up with the rest with the faster processor Snapdragon 800 and newer software. Of course, its 20 megapixel camera is one of its highlights. Next, we have the BlackBerry Z10. Sure, the company might be struggling, but Z10 was the showcase for its latest BlackBerry 10 operating system and hence deserves a place in this list, in our opinion. Finally, we have the Oppo Find 5, one of the first phones to have a Full HD screen. It's also one of the best built Android phones ever with a great dense plastic body. It also has the best music output and a really great stills camera. Highly underrated device, hence we think it earns itself a place on this list here. So there you go folks, these are our Phone Arena's top 10 smartphones of 2013. But what's your pick? And which one of these do you think is the best? Do let us know in the comment section below. We hope you enjoyed this video. Do hit the like button if you did, and do hit the subscribe button if you want more videos like these. Thanks for watching.